Let's discuss about the shape of a liquid meniscus in a tube. Say, in two identical narrow tubes, so we have taken two different type of liquids. In tube 1, we have taken a liquid where angle of contact is an acute angle. That's why you can see at the tangent of the contact of liquid with the boundary or the walls of the tube, the angle theta is less than 90 degrees, and you can see at every point in contact with the, where the liquid is in contact with the tube, the angle made with the tube wall is theta. That's why all the curvatures at the edges will join up and form a meniscus. It is a concave meniscus which is formed. You can see when the angle of contact for a liquid with a solid is less than 90 degrees, then in a tube made up of that solid, when the liquid is filled, a concave meniscus is obtained. And vice versa, we can say when for a given liquid and a solid pair, angle of contact is more than 90 degrees, then we can see when the liquid is filled, at every point where liquid is in contact with the tube wall, the angle made will be obtuse, and due to this only you can see a convex meniscus is obtained. In this situation, if we just analyze what is the effect of formation of meniscus, here we can see if just above and below the meniscus two points A and B are taken, then we can say at point A the surface is having a curvature which is concave. So we can say here pressure at point A is more than pressure at point B. And if R is the radius of curvature for this meniscus, if this is the point we consider as center of curvature of the meniscus, or if we consider this meniscus to be a spherical section like this, and this is the center of curvature, we can say pressure at point A is higher than that of B, and PA minus PB here we can write as 2T by R if T is the surface tension. Similarly, in case of convex meniscus, if we just draw a spherical section and if R is the radius of curvature, here we can say if inside there is point B and outside there is point A, due to the convex nature of this meniscus, we can say pressure at point B will be more than that of A, and here PA will be less than PB, and excess pressure on the side of liquid, and here also PB minus PA can be written as 2T by R. And in this situation, if we talk about the pressure at the bottom point of the liquid, if liquid is filled up to a height H, so we can say just at a height H above at point B, pressure was PB, then at the bottom pressure will be PB plus H rho G. And in this liquid also, if the column height is H, then in this situation also at bottom pressure can be written as PB plus H rho G. But in the two situations, there is a difference that, like on both the cases, pressure at point A is equals to atmospheric pressure. In this situation, pressure at B will be less than pressure at A. So we can say here PB is less. And in this situation, if we calculate PB, here PB will be more than A. So if here pressure is P1, here pressure is P2, we can directly write P2 will be more than P1, even though the liquid fill in the two tubes are at almost equal levels. But due to the curvature and the surface tension of the liquid, pressure at the bottom of the tubes will not be same, it will be different, and the difference can be simply obtained by using this expression.